I started a center at the University of Chicago, and we're trying to help make the world a better place. I've studied criminal justice for the last 20 years, and it struck me that it made no sense that existing electronic monitoring didn't take advantage of GPS technology. Instead, it used a 1970s technology, and I was able to get a meeting with the sheriff, Tom Dart, and I told him what I had in mind. And his first statement to me was, I hate electronic monitoring. And his second statement was, I want to get GPS on everybody. We have an electronic monitoring tomorrow. And it's been great working with the Cook County Sheriff's Office. Back in March, we were able to launch our program, which is electronic monitoring with GPS technology. And over that time, we've had over 2,000 people through the program. So the standard technology for electronic monitoring involves putting a bracelet on someone, and it uses what's called an RF technology. And so when someone leaves their home, then it sends a signal to the department saying that they're in violation. They've moved out of the range. Okay? But that's it. It doesn't know where you are. It just knows that you're gone. And it just seems crazy that is the standard in criminal justice, that in a world in which every cell phone has GPS, but the ankle bracelets that we monitor people with don't have that. The goal would be that we could link in real time the movements of people who are on electronic monitoring, say to the ShotSpotter technology, which in the city of Chicago gives a signal every time gunshots are fired. And this would be an invaluable tool to the police in the sense that we wouldn't know at all whether a person who was wearing a bracelet had, say, committed a crime, but we would know they were at the scene of a crime where shots had been fired. And we also would have the technology to find them quickly, and they could be very valuable witnesses. They might be, in fact, the perpetrator. But that's ultimately, I think, the way you could use this technology extremely effectively. But I wouldn't missell this technology as being primarily a technology of law and order, of enforcement. Really, the ultimate promise of the technology is that when people are on this technology, they understand that they're being watched. They understand that if they commit crimes, they're likely to be caught. Consequently, they commit many fewer crimes. And since they commit almost no crimes, so we've had, in fact, of the 2,000 participants we've had through this program, we have only 4 documented cases of having someone at a scene of a crime over the last 6 months. So if they know that they'll be caught committing crimes, they don't commit crimes. And the beauty of that is that if people aren't going to commit crimes, then we don't have to hold them in prison. So it's really a virtuous circle whereby, in the end, I believe what we can do with this technology is dramatically reduce the prison population while at the same time dramatically reducing crime. And that's what gets me so excited about it.